Friends, this story has been around on the internet for a while. Consider it more of a metaphor, if you will. It's not factually correct. Well, that's why they call it a story, right? It's not a true story. By the way, if it would be true, would we still call it a story? Okay, jokes apart, I do feel this fictional tale that I'm about to tell you will inspire you to pause and think about your life, especially how you perceive challenges, change, and competition in your life. The story is titled, How the Japanese Get Fresh Fish Every Day. The Japanese, they're known for their love for fresh fish. However, the waters close to Japan have not held much fish for decades. So to feed the Japanese population, fishing boats got bigger and went farther than ever before. The farther the fishermen went, the longer it took to bring in the fish. If the return trip took more than a few days, the fish were not fresh. The Japanese, they didn't like the taste. To solve this problem, fishing companies installed freezers on their boats. They would catch the fish, freeze them at sea. Freezers allowed the boats to go further and stay longer. However, the Japanese could still taste the difference between fresh fish and frozen, and they did not like frozen fish. The frozen fish brought a lower price. It was a question of the survival of the fishing industry. So the fishing companies came up with a very creative solution. Let's install fish tanks on the trawlers. They would catch the fish and stuff them in the tanks, fin to fin. After a little thrashing around, the fish stopped moving. They were tired and dull, but alive. Unfortunately, the Japanese could still taste the difference. Because the fish did not move for days altogether, they lost their fresh fish taste. The Japanese preferred the lively taste of fresh fish, not the sluggish fish. So, million-dollar question there. How did Japanese fishing companies solve this problem? And how do Japanese fish stay fresh? So according to the story, to keep the fish tasting fresh, the Japanese fishing companies still put the fish in the tanks, but now they add a small shark to each tank. The small shark eats a few fish, but most of the fish arrive in a very lively state. So a small shark, that's all it took, a small shark, to ensure that these fish would constantly be on the move, that they were alert, awake, agile, and alive. Friends, do you know at times we also feel like these sluggish, dull, bored fish, feeling low, lost, pessimistic? And it's because there are no sharks in our tanks. My message is this: welcome the sharks, or go and find them. And in my experience, there are these three species of sharks that will be particularly very helpful to inject passion and purpose into your dull existence. Number one, change. Number two, challenges. Number three, competition. It turns out these three C's are the strongest triggers of human evolution and growth. And these also happen to be the things that most people are usually very scared of, and they want to avoid them at all costs. We hate change. We run away from challenges, and we dislike competition. In the ideal world, we wouldn't want these three C's around. But having these sharks in your tanks, as unsettling as it is, my friends, these are precisely the factors that will push you to greatness. And think about a life without these three C's, without change, challenges, and competition for a moment. You'd be bored to death, just like the Japanese fish in the story. In fact, I wouldn't even call it living, I'd call it existing. And there's a huge difference between the two. As we close this short video, I'll leave you with this quote by Martin Luther King Jr., who said, "Our very survival depends on our ability to stay awake, to adjust to new ideas, to remain vigilant, and to face the the challenge of change. This was Simerjeet Singh. Thanks for tuning in.